Welcome to Ask a Personal Trainer podcast, brought to you by ForeverFit.tv with your host, Nicola Riley, here to help you find real health and wellness.
Hey, welcome to the show. I'm Nicola Riley, your online personal trainer, nutrition and lifestyle coach with the online gym at foreverfit.tv/online gym. In today's episode, I am going to be talking about how do you get more variety into your training in order to be able to increase the performance that you get out of your training, increase the energy that you expend, boost your metabolism, and ultimately get more results from your training. So here are some tips on how you can prevent your body from plateauing and sticking at where it is at the moment. So tip number one, mix up free weights with machine weights. Now, whenever you head into a gym, now the reason I want to talk so much about this is because there's so many different 24-hour gyms out there where you have access to all of this sort of equipment, but you have no idea how to do them. Now, most of these gyms, there's going to be a circuit set up with a whole lot of different machines, and a really good way for you to utilize these circuit areas is for you to mix up free weights by using these machines. Now, there's going to be certain machines that you're going to know how to use, and there's going to be certain machines that are going to work really well for your body. So a great thing for you to do is grab some dumbbells and head into that circuit area, and you line up a whole lot of the machines that you know are going to work for you, and in between those you're going to include some exercises that incorporate dumbbells. So instead of you just thinking that you have to use those machines and then traipse off to another room, bring the dumbbells in and do. So there might be a leg press machine, and so you might go and do some the leg press, and then you can might combine that with some dumbbell shoulder presses and do that as a circuit, upper body, lower body, and then you might mix that up with something else where you do a lat pull down using the machine, and then you might combine that with some lunges using the dumbbells. So combine the free weights and the machines to get a really effective workout and to just to give that body a new change and mix things up. Another thing that you can do to your training is add little bouts of cardio into your workouts. So you might have a weight style training that you've done, but in between the weights that you do, where you might have a rest period for your upper body, jump on a bike for 30 seconds and incorporate some really intense sprints on that bike, and then go back and do that shoulder press exercise. By incorporating these little wee interval boosts of intensity, you're not only going to boost your metabolism more, but you're getting those really amazing benefits from that metabolic sort of training, and that anaerobic hit that those intervals create. So this is then going to turn just a normal weight workout into a really good fat burning, metabolism boosting workout. Another thing that you can do is before you head into your typical RPM class or your typical body balance class, or you might have a combat class that you're doing, or you might have a group training session that you do, pre-work your muscles out before you head into it. So give your body something that's given it a little bit of a shock. So your body gets used to what it's used to. So it's a really good idea to throw some things in there that are giving it like a curveball. So before you head into like an RPM class, for example, or a spin class, do some squats with some heavy weights and a couple of box jumps and pre-exhaust those muscles, and then head into the RPM and notice the difference of what your body's having to adapt to instead of sitting at the same intensity that you're used to. Or before you head into doing like a pump class, you might decide that you want to do like a full body circuit with some really good heavy weights, and then you're using that body pump class as a cherry on the top. Or if you're in the online gym, you're combining like HIIT workouts and then you're doing a core workout on the end. Or you might combine an extreme workout, and then which is really exhausting the body, getting all those gymnastic Olympic moves happening, and then you're putting on some really good stretching, mobility, or a cool workout on the end of that. Just mixing things up and pre or post working, exhausting your muscles before you head into the actual workout that you're going to, can get some huge benefits for your body. Another really cool thing that you can do is actually hire a personal trainer. Now, often people think that when they get a personal trainer, that trainer has to be somebody that they're going to be locked in for the next 6 or 12 weeks. But often a really good idea is just to hire a trainer for a one-off session and get them to write you or just take you through a whole lot of really new exercises that you might not have considered. Ask them for some variety and ask them for a new workout that's going to challenge your body and take it to another level. And this is a great way just to get the most out of a personal training session and for you just to learn some new exercises and get the guidance of a trainer on the technique and how to do them properly. Some other things that you can do is add more walking into your week. If your body's plateaued at the moment and you're just doing the same old routine that you have been doing for a really long time, add some more walking in. You cannot beat low intensity movement, and the more you get in, the better. So ask yourself, are you getting good 6 hours of walking in per week? In all honesty, you most probably aren't, so you want to make sure at least 30 minutes every day you're getting in a good quality walk, and then notice the benefits that that has not only to your energy but also to your results in a couple of weeks as well. Then try adding sprinting in once a week. There is absolutely nothing better than sprinting for your body. The metabolic and the hormonal response that happens when you sprint is like nothing other. So start by introducing sprint intervals, and this might be something where you sprint for 20 seconds and you recover for a minute, and then you sprint again 20 seconds, recover for a minute, and you're just going to build up the amount of sprinting that you're able to do. Or you might have some other sprinting intervals that you may do inside the online gym or the weekly schedules that we have. I have different sprinting drills and intervals that everybody does each and every week. So mixing it up every week so they're keeping the body guessing and so that you're going to continue to get results from your sprinting. Another thing that you can do is try and add in some compound exercises after you've finished a weight exercise. So what this means is that, say for example, you do some heavy squats and then you combine that with some vertical jumps afterwards. And what this does is it like shocks your muscles and you're going to get a huge boost in your body. And this is not only going to boost your metabolism, it's going to get that whole everything working in your hormonal system. It's not only going to improve your energy, but it's going to help to push you through that plateau that you're experiencing. So squats followed by vertical jumps, you might do some heavy shoulder press followed by either some press up jumps or some med ball throws over your head. Or you might do some lunges with some jump lunges following afterwards that. Some other things you can do is like little mini circuits for a particular muscle part. So for example, you're working your chest, you might do a press up, a chest press, some flies and some Swiss ball press ups, and you might do that as a circuit and then recover. Then you might move into another part of your body where you might do squats, deadlifts, box jumps and sumo squats all combined into one, and then you move on to another body part. All of these things are about shocking your body, saying, oi, wake up, we need to snap out of this, we need to get stronger, we need to get fitter, because she's switching things up. So give your body some variety, look into your training and see which ways you can add more variety into your training, and use these tips to prevent yourself from plateauing and staying the same old, and remember it's really important to mix up your routine always. So if you haven't already, make sure you check out all the programs in the online gym. We've got everything from half marathon training through to a beginner's running program, 30-day core challenge, fat burning program, fitness through pregnancy, everything in there to help you get yourself safely fit, get your training right so that you get results out of your training, so you're not overtraining, but you're doing smart, effective training, following really good programs to help you get results, help you get variety, and you've also got a complete exercise library with video workouts all to help you get the most out of your training. So check it out, foreverfit.tv/online gym. And if you haven't already, sign up to my newsletter, get weekly updates on all the advice that you need to help you find real health and wellness, or check out the Facebook page foreverfit.tv. Until next time, have a fabulous week. The materials and content in this podcast are there to educate and to inform. There's no substitute for professional care by a doctor or other qualified medical professional. This podcast is provided on the understanding that it does not constitute medical or other professional advice or services. Instead, I encourage you to discuss your options with your healthcare provider who knows your condition and your health history. Guests who speak on this podcast express their own opinions, experience, and conclusions. Nicola Riley encourages you to make your own healthcare decisions based on your research and in partnership with your qualified healthcare professional.